Sports, a special Martin Luther King Day edition. This is Kevin Harlan, joined by Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and on the sideline, David Aldridge. We've got the Boston Celtics taking on the Detroit Pistons. So Detroit will get the first possession. And now the opening lineup for Boston. Rajon Rondo is out there with Tony Allen. Then it's Pierce. Then there's Leon Poe. And it's Garnett in at the four.
Yeah, he runs the floor with a purpose that time. Excellent play. You know what? And a late reaction by the transition D takes it himself uncontested.
Lanita, and he dunks it down.
And this guy is a scoring machine. I mean, I know I'm not the only one to describe him that way.
Here's Poe. It's hauled in by Lanier. And so is Detroit with the ball. And there's the pass to Thomas. Look at six. Detroit needs to get out the shot. Lanier, that's good.
And setting the tone early with a strong move to the rack.
First quarter, got it really testing the defense. Trying to find their weaknesses.
Allen dishes to Rondo. Garnett kicks to Rondo. Back to Garnett. Poked away. Pass to Poe. Out left to the wing. Tries again. And the shot is good from Garnett. Garnett's got his first basket of the night.
High percentage play. Working the ball in close. Then the nice move to convert.
They set the screen. Here's Hill. And here we go with Allen. Running it up the court. Garnett the pass to Allen. Shoots over Dumars. There's Allen. That's good on the assist from Kevin Garnett. Allen's got his second basket of the night. Pass to Lanier. Outside Thomas. Here's Lanier. Oh, went in there and tried to power it down, but drew contact. He'll head to the line.
Wow, that is a strong move there to go in for the dunk.
First trip to the line for him here.
Taking two shots.
First free throw is good. He's perfect from the line this time.
It's been a really good day for him at the line. Some other bigs have no documented problems on their free throws. He's not one of them.
It's good.
This is why you like to get him touches. He makes things happen.
First quarter basketball, just over 2.5 minutes play. Here's Allen, and it's Boston with another.
I'm not entirely sure what the defensive strategy was there, but it worked poorly. He loves taking that shot.
Pistons trail by four. Now here's Thomas. They set the screen, and the basket by Hill.
Look, this is how you draw it up coming out of the locker room. 3 of 3 so far.
Back to Pierce, over Hill. The shot by Pierce will not go.
I can tell you right now, the coach loved everything about that shot except the result.
Allen in the post, covered by Dumars. Garnett kicks to Allen. Second shot opportunity, and Garnett puts it in. Garnett's got his second bucket.
Just an innate ability to rebound the basketball and then make the offense pay. When he gets a few of those early, look out. It gets his blood pumping. And suddenly there's nobody who can hold him.
Pierce, and sticking right with it, gets the foul with the bucket, and he'll go to the line.
And defensively, this is a nightmare. He's already on a roll. Well, obviously, this was the strategy coming in. Feed him the rock and let him go to work.
He throw good, Paul Pierce. Pistons trail by five. Passes to Lanier. Rajon Rondo with the rebound. And the Celtics with possession here. This one for three. Gets it to go from beyond the arc.
Oh, great ball movement there.
And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Thanks, Kevin. I did speak with the Pistons head coach for a little while. He's confident in their ability to win the battle of the low post. That's where he'd like to see most of the action take place. Kevin, I think we can expect them to pound the ball. chance to get. Let their big man go to work.
Thank you, David. The Celtics have made their only other free throw attempt today in an earlier trip to the line. A different look here for Detroit. Klay Thompson comes in for Hill, and Chauncey Billups is subbed in for Joe Dumars. That's good from Pierce. And Smitty, I heard somewhere that both Larry Bird and Kevin Durant did a lot of wrist strengthening exercises when they were growing up. How important is wrist strength to basketball players, and especially shooters like yourself?
You know, when you talk the game or shoot the basketball, Kevin, they say get your legs into it. But there's sometimes you are in situations where all you have to do is use your arms and your wrist. And you see guys right now from a flat-out standstill position, deep behind the three-point line, a la Kevin Durant, Steph Curry. They're just shooting with all arms and wrists. So it is very important to shoot with your wrist and your arms.
Did you do that? Did you do any of that wrist strengthening when you played? And did you hear that?
I did. Kevin, all I did was do some push-ups.
We talk about it all the time, guys. Those second-chance buckets are always the result of that extra effort.
PG, that's good. Garnett's got his third basket of the night right there.
And the story here, Kevin, early on, is how well they shot the basketball.
Here's the pusher. That shot misses. And the Celtics going the other way now. Pierce against Thomas. And Pierce gets it to go on the assist by Rondo.
Timely passing leads to assists, and that's been the recipe for success.
Dishes it to the pusher. On the wing, Thompson. Outside Thomas. Connects from three-point range.
And defensively, you've got to make a greater effort working over the screens.
Yeah, he could have made a better choice. He left him an easy one. Let's see how he plays the next game.
Yeah, tremendous hustle. Just to get a hand on that one.
Reads the play, quick reaction, almost comes up with that steal.
Austin Air going to switch here. Pierce is checked in. The shot's good from Poe.
And that's a great play on the backboard for him. I mean, it's what we expect. All his second chance points do not come by accident.
Now, here's the push. Now 8 seconds separating the two clocks. Here's Lanier. As he grabs the miss.
You know that's what he likes to have, that point-blank range, and he misses.
Out of bounds, Detroit takes possession. 9 seconds left to play in the first. Knocked loose, and it's out of bounds. Last touch by Thomas. And there's the pass to Peterson. Fades away. And so it's Boston in the driver's seat. Up 8 points at the end of the quarter. A terrific tempo and a great pace. The fast break has been a central part of their offense. Back to the action after this word. Sports broadcast of the NBA celebrating Martin Luther King Day. When you consider how the Celtics are doing, guys, what jumps out to you stats-wise?
Yeah, it didn't take them long to get that transition game going.
No. What?
Celtics leading by 8. You got Chauncey Billups. DeBuscher is out there with Klay Thompson. And it's Jerry Stackhouse, and it's Lanier in at the 5 spot. That's the 5 on the 4 for the Pistons. Perkins kicks to Pierce. Over Thompson. The shot by Pierce will not go.
Not sure of the thought process on that one. Really bad shot selection.
Well, you're playing for the team, not just yourself. They needed much better execution that trip down the floor.
Here's Rondo. Pass to Peterson. Garnett kicks to Pierce. 6 on the shot clock. Fires from deep. Again, the miss by the Celtics.
And even against defense as tight as that, you almost expect him to steal early goals.
It's tipped. Rondo against Billups. Here Here's Perkins. Here's Garnett. That one, no good. Excellent D there from DeBuscher. Here's Rondo. Goes to the reverse layup and drops it in. Rondo's got 5 points so far.
They're scoring boatloads of buckets. It's raining buckets from inside.
Phillips dishes to Stackhouse. DeBuscher with the screen. There's the whistle. The legal screen.
That's sort of a picture of what not to do on those last two possessions. They're being way too loose with the ball.
Hill is checked in for Detroit. Garnett the pass to Pierce. Another shot. And Garnett, that's good. 8 points for him.
And when the score is as lopsided as it is, and you can see they smell blood in the water, Hot Man is going for the jugular.
And the Pistons decide to take their first timeout right here.
And look, you never want to see a team gut you this way. Really a good timeout.
Some of this is just a matter of toughness, a willingness to play physical inside, something we're not seeing.
Phillips kicks to Stackhouse. Nice ball movement by Detroit. Goes up on the line. Cut, and the Summit lead has been cut down to just 8 points with the bucket for him. Here's Rondo. It's in. It's his third field goal of the game. He's 3 for 5.
They're doing a really good job of getting the ball inside and attacking. I mean, that's an area they have completely dominated.
Oh, and it looks like that's going to be a goaltending call. Yep, that's it. So they'll get the basket.
That's a very close call. I'm sure he thinks it's a clean block, but looks like it was on the way down.
Pierce against Hill. The shot by Pierce will not go.
You can see it. He's way out of sync. It's been this way all quarter for him.
It's stolen by Rondo. And now Pierce running the floor all by himself.
Yeah, you see the killer instinct. He's going for the death blow.
True story. They got a monster lead that's taking a life of its own.
DeBuscher, Garnett grabs the board. Garnett's got 6 rebounds now in the game. Pierce, good.
Yeah, the onslaught continues. He's been unstoppable now for a couple of nights.
The momentum is building, scoring in a bunch of ways. That's why his number keeps getting called.
And stolen by Perkins. And Spears in the corner. Over Hill. Here's Garnett. He can't get that one. Excellent D there from DeBuscher. Checked in by Pierce.
Two shots, gentlemen.
Shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night.
Two.
Free throw good to DeBuscher. DeBuscher hits them both. Celtics leading by 11. Here's Pierce on a piece of it. Outside, Billups. Broke loose. Rondo with the steal. Inside, here's Garnett. And it's good, coming on the assist by Rajon Rondo. Garnett's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Up by a bunch. He's still pushing the action, trying to impose his will.
With this big of a deficit in the score, you think the losing team would be playing harder? Nope, the opposite.
And the basket by Pierce. Pierce has got 17.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Pass to Here's the screen. Knocked away. Shot clock at 6. Here's Stackhouse. Rebound, Boston. Garnett's got 8 rebounds in this game. Kicks it to Rondo. Rebound. Detroit takes possession. And the Pistons making a change here. Thomas is checked in. Boston also with the sub. Brown's checked in. 1:46 left in the first half of basketball. Time called here. The Pistons decide to talk it over.
It's hard to disagree with the timeout here, as the team badly needs to regain focus. They're out of sync offensively, way too many turnovers, and looking frustrated. They need to get back to their pace, their brand of basketball.
Boston making a switch here. Rondo against Thomas. Over Rondo. Moves back up. He lays it in. 10 points for him.
The shooting has really been there for him today, but he may have to take it on himself to continue to carry this team and try and get out of this hole.
The shot by Pierce will not go. Pistons trail by 13. Here's to Buescher. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here. The Pistons shoot their fifth and sixth free throws of the game.
Two shots.
And he makes the first.
After having no trip to the free throw line in the first period, he's being much more aggressive now.
Dumars, he's checked in for Detroit. DeBuescher hits them both.
And working, Kevin, themselves to the line here in the second. A nice way to get your offense going.
Pierce against Hill. Pierce, good. Pierce has got 19 points.
They're getting on a roll inside. Their last three field goals have come from the paint.
It's stolen by Allen. Here's Poe. Rondo kicks to Pierce. That's good, coming on the assist by Rajon Rondo. Rondo's got his fourth assist in this one. Pistons trail by 16. Thomas dishes to Dumars. Feeds to DeBuescher. And Dumars makes it to go.
And they've repeatedly probed inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid off.
Pierce kicks to Brown. Pierce, the pass to Brown. Back to Pierce. Over Hill, six on the shot clock. The shot by Pierce will not go. It's stolen by Allen. Up in time. He doesn't hit that one. And we finish one half of basketball. Celtics lead by 14. Stay with us, folks. We'll get back just after halftime to start the third quarter. It's the Skyline in downtown Detroit. And welcome back to our special presentation of the NBA for Martin Luther King Day. We're seeing a tremendous game from Paul Pierce.
And every team needs this, a guy who challenges the defense with that slashing ability.
You know,
Celtics leading by 14. Our second half of basketball and presented by Gatorade. Our team is all fueled up and on the floor to start the third. On the floor for Boston. Pierce is out there with Garnett. And it's Rajon Rondo. Then there's Leon Pope. And it's Allen in at the two-guard spot. Thomas dishes to DeBuescher. And Hill has it in the corner. And the foul on Paul Pierce. That'll be his second foul of the game. Thomas against Rondo. DeBuescher with the screen. Just five to shoot. Hill gets to Thomas. Good, the assist goes to Hill. Thomas got six.
And there's where, if you get some room, you kind of have to take that shot to keep the defense honest.
Oh, misses. For Boston, they come into this one following the loss to the Magic. There's the double team with Allen. Knocks it loose. Dumars against Allen. Dumars, the pass to him. For three. But they get it back. Outside Thomas. Gets back to Hill. Tries again. And it's good on the way. He's got eight.
And that's how you want to come out of the locker room. He is fired up.
Yes, in the first minute or so, you knock down a couple shots. You are in rhythm.
And the shot is good.
This is what your spacing is designed to do. Find cracks in the defense.
Now a timeout called by Detroit.
Yeah, he's shaking up a bit. No choice but to take a timeout and let him get some medical attention.
Here's Dumars. Here's DeBuescher. And he uses the glass on the lane.
Strong move at the rim. Overpowers the smaller defender.
Here's Allen from 13 feet. It goes down. Allen's got four this quarter.
You like the aggressiveness. Pushing all the right buttons. He has this this team rolling.
Rondo against Thomas. Rondo's shot is off. Pistons trail by 13. Hill has the open one. And good. Out the friendly bounce off the right side of the rim. Hill's got 10 points in the game.
They might be behind, but you can't blame him. He has been spectacular so far in this one.
How about that move? You'll see very few players able to pull off just sensational stuff.
Fires from 14. Rebound Boston. At one point, they led by 16. There's the dish to Garnett. Pierce up top. Looks for Garnett. He gets it to him. Using his post move to get the 2 points. He's got 12.
His teammates recognize that he has the hot hand going. That's why they give him the ball every chance they get.
Thomas kicks to the bush. And yes, it's good.
Loves the assist. I mean, he knew exactly where that bounce pass had to be to create that opportunity.
Rondo dishes to Garnett. The feed to Pierce. The Celtics working the ball around now. Here's Rondo, and it's tipped. Now, DeBusschere. 12 points for him. Thomas passes to DeBusschere. Thomas against Rondo. Passes it to Lanier. Down to 5 on the shot clock. It's going to be a 24-second shot clock violation. They turn it over. Now the team's checked in for Dumont.
Get on Rondo!
Rondo kicks to Garnett. And he got the whistle, so he'll have a 3-point play opportunity.
Almost an impossible shot to block at the post. The defender can't give up that much of a height advantage and expect to contest it.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight. Detroit making a switch here. Thompson's checked in. Kevin Garnett, no good on the free throw. Pistons trail by 15. Thomas kicks to Thompson. The pass to Lanier. That's it. Coming off the assist from Thompson. Lanier's got 12 in the game. Johnson gets to Allen. Over Hamilton. Again, the miss by the Celtics.
He was all alone. Looks like he gets a little too relaxed. He has to maintain his focus.
Is it me, or does it just feel like he gets every rebound that comes up?
No, it's felt like that all game. He is just aggressive and finds ways to snag rebounds out of thin air sometimes.
Thomas kicks to DeBusschere. They set the pick. Thompson, a screen on Garnett. DeBusschere with it. Now Garnett defending. Two on the clock. And they force the shot clock violation. Great team. Chauncey Billups checked in for Detroit. And a change for the Celtics. Brown is checked in for Kevin Garnett. Here's Rondo. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up. It's going to be on Chauncey Billups.
No question he got bumped on that shot.
Boston shooting their fourth and fifth shots at the foul line in the game.
Two.
And he makes the first. And Rondo drops them both. Pistons trail by 15. Now a timeout called by Detroit. A minute 20 left to play in the third. They set the pick. Billups kicks to Thompson. Let's it fly from 18. Lanier, no good.
Boy, he loves that mid-range jumper. Just fails to create enough room to operate.
missing. And it's Detroit's ball. Down by 15. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Tony Allen. That's his first foul. Outside, Billups. Lines out of bounds. The Celtics will take it the other way. And here's Rondo. 13 points in the game. For the three. It's rebounded by DeBuscher. DeBuscher's got his third rebound on the night.
Well, he had one three-pointer in the first half, but so far in the second, he's come up with goose eggs. And not relying at all on a three-point shot. They may want to rethink about stretching the defense a bit like they did in that first half.
This is a guy who knows how to orchestrate an offense. Terrific lead pass.
Got a piece of it. There's the pick. A shot by Thompson. No one's around. Trails the three-pointer. Thompson's got 7 points in the game.
And defensively, you've got to make a greater effort working over the screens.
Yeah, he could have made a better choice. Yeah. He left him an easy one. Let's see how he plays the next one.
And so it's Boston, enjoying a 12-point lead as they talk things over during the break. They've been active hands, and of course, a lot of turnovers in this one. Right back after this break. Welcome back to the 2K Sports Broadcast of the NBA, celebrating Martin Luther King Day. Pistons trail by 12. We've got Richard Hamilton. Klay Thompson is out there with DeBuscher. And there's Chauncey Billups. And it's Lanier in at the center position. That's the group for Detroit right now. Brown, right side. Over Lanier. That misses off the back.
Well, this is where he's inconsistent, and that can slow down your team's momentum.
Dishes it to Billups. Allen against Hamilton. Stolen by Allen. It's tipped. Stolen by DeBuscher. He dishes it to Hamilton. Shoots from the elbow. And he connects with the jumper. Hamilton's got the fourth quarter going with the first basket of the period here for the Pistons. Austin leading by 10. Here's Rondo. That's good. It's his seventh made basket in 14 tries.
And that's just showing off right there, guys. I mean, he is too good with that crossover.
From deep, Billups, another three for Detroit.
I mean, just a good shooter taking what the defense allows. Find some space out beyond the arc.
Peterson misses. And so it's Detroit with the ball. The teardrop, and he could not get that one to go. Lot of contact, and he'll go to the line for two. One free throw good from Thompson. Hill is checked in for Hamilton. And then for Boston. Leon Poe's checked in for Brown. Garnett comes in for Johnson. And Pierce subbed in for him. Garnett doesn't go that time. And Detroit the other way now. Here's Hill. Here's DeBuscher. Pass to Lanier. They get a hand on it. It's Pierce on the wing. He's guarded by Hill. Fires from 14. The shot by Pierce will not go.
They've been the better rebounding team by a healthy margin, but it hasn't been enough.
And it's Rondo penetrating. Second chance effort, and that's 2 points on the layup.
Second chance opportunities. The great equalizer.
Pistons trail by 9. Billups hits to DeBuscher. And now here's Rondo, the fast break opportunity. There's one on the play. Bucket's good. He'll go to the line.
A lot of basketball comes down to recognizing mismatches and taking advantage of them like he did.
Dumars, he's checked in for the Pistons. Thomas comes in for Chauncey Billups. A free throw good from Kevin Garnett. Detroit with the ball. Pass to DeBuscher. Back to Thomas. High post try, rebounded by the Celtics. At one point, they led by 16. And Pierce, here we go. And the shot is long. Hill against Pierce. Hill dishes to Thomas. Pierce with the steal. A bit under 3.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth. Rondo passes to Garnett. That shot is on. Excellent D there from the pusher. He feeds it to Dumars. To the wing right side. Thomas, it's a wide open look. Nice teamwork to set up the pick point and make the space for the Jays.
It's a hard pick there that allowed his teammates to get open and get a clean look at the basket.
For three, Pierce. Basket is good. The assist from Rondo. Rondo's got his 7th assist in the game. Now a timeout called by Detroit.
Yeah, I mean, just wants to make sure everybody's on the same page here going forward.
You know, sometimes the best way to approach it, let your guys know what they're doing well and give them one or two things that they could have done better.
Lead by 17.
Yeah, second chance points. Gotta love the way they attack the offensive glass there, even with a huge lead.
That's how they've got to this point in the game. Lots of activity, fantastic focus.
Watch Rondo! Allen outside. Back to Rondo. Over Thomas. Rajon Rondo, the basket on the assist by Allen. Rondo's got 4 this quarter.
And we see it all the time, guys. You get the big lead, maybe check out mentally, but not tonight.
They have this game in hand, but they're still pouring it on.
Rebound, Detroit.
Creativity at its best. But scoreboard points are worth more than style points.
And the call will be against Kevin Garnett. That's foul number 2 for him. And some changes here for the Celtics. Pollard, he's checked in for Poe. Johnson comes in for Kevin Garnett, and it's Brown in for Marshawn Long.
Yeah, going to the floater right there. That was pretty.
It's Pierce with the drive. Got that bucket in and no
time. Timeout.
Pierce has got 27 points.
Sorry. Yeah, might as well tack on a few more points.
Full lead, I guess. This is going to be a dominant lead. Never would stop on how this was going to go. They just totally outworked them today.
Askew's checked in for the Celtics. They get a hand on it. It's stolen by Brown. Outside, Pierce. Fouled in the act of shooting. A 3-point play chance coming up.
And just staying aggressive. Continuing to extend that lead.
They left nothing to chance. This is how you close out.
Good, Paul Pierce. 58 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Outside, Dumars. Passes it to Bing. Knocked away. It's stolen by Brown. Outside, Pierce. The shot's good. Brown making the play. That's now 32 points for Paul Pierce.
And you have to like the location of this pass. Gives it to him where he can do something with it.
Lambert with a screen on Brown. Here's Bing, and they pick up 2.
Not an easy finish right there, but a beautiful move to give himself just enough space to get in close and knock it down.
It's a 4-second differential between the shot clock and game clock. And it's Detroit's ball. He kicks to run. Here's Hamilton. Off target with that shot. And so it's Boston easily grabbing this one. To come into an opponent's building and dominate the win they did tonight says, I think, Greg, an awful lot about this team.
I guess they don't need home cooking to feel at home. I mean, Kevin, just a masterful performance all the way around.
Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and David Alden, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. So long.